So,
are we getting recorded?
Yeah, yeah, it's all.
Oh, fuck.
This is all dirt that I get on people that I blackmail.
Oh, fuck, dude.
Welcome to the fucking show, bro.
Thank you. It's really cool for having me.
You and I have been gymming since, I don't know.
I think we met in MultiFit first.
Bro, we've been gymming
3-4 years
together in MultiFit. Then in, let's not name Parallel, the gym, let's not name the gyms. But
like, for me, you're always that guy who's doing shoulder press over here on my right side.
But looks can be deceptive. But never thought that this guy.
This is a musician. I felt as a difference between Pune and Mumbai.
Okay.
Was that over here, everyone I meet is from the, almost everyone is from the non-arts field.
Most of them.
And over there, whoever I'm meeting, like, hey, I'm an actor. Uh-huh. I direct. Oh, I write. I'm a musician.
Right.
You know? So it's a very different
If someone comes and says...
Like, if art is... What if we live in a world where art is mainstream work, like how offices are mainstream? Am I making sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But you know, economies might collapse like that.
No, not really.
Most of them are struggling. So
not really. So
might not be contributing.
But the concept of economy. Fuck, I was going somewhere with this.
It's all right. But anyway, let's get back to the music. So the music part is that we've been gymming since, I don't know, 3-4 years now.
3-4 years.
Not knowing each other.
Not
but, you know.
And we spoke for the first time recently.
Yeah, aware of each other's existence, but not knowing each other.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when I got to know the music part, I checked your profile. And then I heard a few uploads that you've done on your Instagram. And bro, I have actually written this as my notes. So your music actually has a power to, you know, enter the skin.
Thanks, man. This is...
I'm not like...
This is great. You, I mean, this is what an artist wants. It's
you have to listen to this.
Accolades.
Yeah. So plus, it also makes me happy and it also has the power to make me cry. So you know what music does to a person.
Yeah, right? I mean, that's what it...
It's meant to do
it's
that.
Supposed
it stirs
to,
the emotion, right?
Stir the emotion.
Right,
that's
right.
Exactly
right.
What was coming at. Yeah.
So you did a song, Kaise Hua. From Kabir.
Yeah, Kabir Singh.
Kabir
exactly.
Singh.
So I don't really, I haven't been watching movies in the theater.
Right.
Since a very long time.
Huh.
So I missed this movie, obviously. But
right.
Because I read a lot online and then suddenly something becomes popular and
right.
You see it. So I was like, what is this Kabir Singh?
Controversy.
Yeah,
yeah. Sexist and all that.
Sexist. Ye kya cheez hai, you know?
Right.
So after all this while, I found Kabir Singh on like Netflix, I think.
Yeah.
And I was like, chalo, I have like 2 hours to kill.
Right, right, yeah.
Let's watch
mind,
it, right?
Well, yeah.
So I watched the movie and from a standalone point of view, I think the movie is meh. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's
it didn't
not
do that well. It didn't do that well.
No, it did really well.
Really? Because
it made 300 crores or something like
no
that.
Fucking
yeah,
way.
Bro,
no,
dude, really? Check it out.
Okay.
See, that's the thing. So that is how I found out, na? Because I see all this newsfeed.
Right. Yeah,
exactly. So because of that curiosity, I watched that movie on Netflix.
Right.
And then after watching the movie, the one thing that stuck out is like the music, because basically. They have paid really, they have paid attention to the music part.
Okay,
of,
the entire movie or a particular?
Entire movie.
Okay.
So it's, I was like, hey, this is interesting. So I started listening to songs from that album.
Right.
And the album is pretty good for a Bollywood, you know.
I'll check it out because I've just heard that song. And let me be very honest. So you've done that song, right? It's just a 50-second video.
It's a 1 minute.
1 minute, yeah. The way Instagram works, right? So you have uploaded that video and I heard that song. Bro, then I switched to Spotify and Vishal Mishra has sung the song.
Yeah.
No disrespect to the guy because he's done an amazing job.
He's done a great job, man.
But bro, you know where I'm going. I know, I can see that.
Before you finish, I'm going to stop you right there because Vishal Mishra is a great singer. I mean, I came across this song and then I was like, wow, this is the kind of vocals I've not heard in a long time because I come from a soft classic rock background.
Right.
You know, so as a kid, I was exposed to all kinds of music. My parents listened to a lot of Indian music like Mohammed Rafi, Kishore Kumar, Abhi Barman, Hemant Kumar, Jagjit Singh, Mehdi Hasan, you know, the ghazals then there was Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan saab.
Aise jab bhi unka naam lete hain mere dost aise karte
hain. Of course.
Ustad Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan.
Correct. So and at the same time my sister used to listen to Bon Jovi. And then I had friends in school. Through my friends, I think I got introduced to The Police, Queen, Beatles, Elvis Presley.
Nice.
So it's always been like, and most of my school years and college years, I've been listening to bands like Aerosmith, Kiss, Queen. I'm a big fan of Queen, huge fan. That's a different topic that because I hated the movie.
Okay.
Because, okay, that's another topic altogether. So,
was it the actor?
No, not the actor. It was a fuck-all biopic. As in, I mean, my language.
If it was fuck-all, then it was fuck-all.
No, because, see, firstly, the thing is like when I watch movies, I start noticing flaws and plot holes that ye side se aaya to how did he leave
that kind of guy.
So for example, there's this scene in Bohemian Rhapsody where Mary Austin,
I haven't seen the movie.
I've seen, okay, so okay, so are you aware of
the movie? In general, I know that he has,
I'll just tell you the scene roots. So she's, you've not watched the movie, so it won't make sense, but still, okay, fine. So she's she lives opposite Freddie's house.
Uh-huh.
So from the window of her bedroom, she can see the living room of Freddie Mercury.
Right.
Okay. So there's one scene, she looks at him and he's all fucked up, right? And she's like, okay, fine.
Like, is he high on drugs or his own?
No, he's ill.
Oh, he's ill.
He's become ill by that time. So she goes to see him and all that shit. And then she comes and then catches a cab at the end of the scene and goes away. I was like, don't you live like right here? Why did you catch a
cab? Must have gone somewhere else, bro.
No, where? I'm going home.
Now I know.
I'm going home.
What kind of viewer you are?
Exactly, man. I noticed these things.
You wanted to grab a fucking coffee. I don't know.
Exactly. I noticed these things. At that time of the day, it's supposed to be like 1 in the night, it's raining. And you know, that typical, I'm going, you know. That movie shit. Like,
you like to dissect stuff. Yeah,
it just comes. I don't do it consciously. It just comes.
Sure.
So when I was watching Kabir Singh.
Yeah, exactly. So let me get back to this. I'm just saying that guy is an amazing artist.
Mm.
But so I have this habit of playing a song while working on something on my laptop, right?
Okay.
Bro, I put my headphones on your 50-second ka video and I work for 15-20 minutes. So
on a repeat.
All I had to do was this because the light goes off. So when you take a dip to...
Did you actually like it or were you just trying to figure out ki...
No. So the dip that you take for kaise hua, right? I'm not going to do that. But before that, it was different from the original soundtrack.
Yeah.
And it was good, bro. So
that's the thing. Like, even if I do covers, I feel... as a musician, not just a singer, every musician wants to play his instrument his way, his or her way. Want to be like...
Yeah, fingerprint, right?
Yeah.
You need to give...
It exactly. Your... So, as a singer, I feel imitation is not a good way to go about it because...
a lot of singers do that, right? If they're singing Bryan Adams' song, they'll try to copy Bryan Adams' ka husky
voice. So, the thing is like, we all have had that phase. I wouldn't lie about it. Even I, at one point... when I used to do like in my college days, like my competition days, competition days, that was when I used to try to emulate the singer I'm covering, right?
Right.
Like Bryan Adams ka, Bryan Adams ka gaana, like you try to sing like Bryan Adams.
With that voice, right?
Exactly.
Rough husky voice.
Yeah, and you fake it.
Exactly, you know? Yeah.
So, you can't keep doing that if you want to get into like be a singer.
Makes sense,
you know?
Yeah.
So I try to be as original as possible. Right. I just use my voice as an instrument.
What a beautiful voice, bro.
Thanks.
I heard Dil Hai Chota Sa as well, that you...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
thank
really.
You.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
So I want to know, it's been what, since how long have you been in this field? 14 years, I remember you said.
2006, so 2020, so 14
sure,
years. Yeah,
sure,
it will be 14 years.
Nice.
Like,
so
I've just been doing like a lot of
so
gigs.
Kaise hua?
I started off with pub gigs, like I just started.
No, that moment of truth, that how did you, okay, singing.
Singing, I've been singing since the age of 3.
Okay. Knowing the fact that you're singing? Or just wailing
yeah,
at the
yeah, it just like I think I was just like naturally I liked hearing like because as I said my parents used to listen to a lot of great singers,
right?
You know, and the thing about Bollywood songs,
mm-hmm.
it's always vocal centric.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
around like the way it's made. You nowadays I think there's a good balance coming in. But the thing is, like, if you listen to old songs, it's always everything, the production, the composition is always revolving around the voice.
Okay.
Like, abhi na jao chhod kar.
Okay.
You know, that song.
I didn't get what you mean when you did this.
How, like,
it's
okay,
more of
when
lyrics,
you listen,
more
so
of lyrics
example,
and less of.
No. For example, when you listen to an old song.
Right.
Old Bollywood number.
Right.
Right.
I'll talk about my favorite song.
I don't think we should use the word Bollywood because
Indian
we should just call Hindi. Hindi.
Yeah. So, Aadat Pad Gayi Bollywood Kya song. So, that main har fikr ko dhuye mein udaat chala. Yeah, that's my favorite Bollywood number. Yeah. So,
like one of the classics.
Right.
So when you listen to the song, you're just focusing on the words.
Sure. Yeah.
Because it's being played on screen, right?
Right.
So
the guy is acting and vocals, like lyrics.
Yeah, because it's being acted on screen, na?
Okay.
So
yeah, exactly.
How else will an actor can act
express,
out a sarod solo or a sitar solo?
Yes, yes.
You know?
Yeah.
Or an instrumental track. So
right.
The main thing is the voice. So
right.
That's the reason it's constructed in a way where the voice is the center of attention.
Okay.
Like, that's how Bollywood songs are made. Now, if you listen to independent artists, bands, like, it's a mixture of everything. That's
right.
The reason there's a difference.
So, how did it affect your thing? Because you started listening to songs when you were...
Exactly. It's like, as a kid, you just like what you like.
Right, right yeah.
So, I used to just randomly sing full day.
So, did you get spotted by someone ki, yeah, teri awaaz achhi? Like, how did you get that push that I should go into this field?
When I think I was 11 or 12,
okay,
I had this friend who I used to jam with, school friend,
right?
And I was singing in his house, and I don't know, his maid or his I think his maid,
okay,
was like, you sing well.
Oh, right, that was your first, you know,
yeah, yeah.
Okay,
then I was like, okay,
right.
And I started singing more.
But you like came from a mate, so yeah, you didn't give that much interest.
No, man. I wasn't going there
to joke.
What the fuck, man?
Anyway, yeah. So yeah, mate was the first thing.
Yo, so mate was, so that was the first time a stranger, like
yeah.
At home.
Appreciated.
My parents used to tell other people, you know, when you're a kid, your parents are like,
dance.
Tell their friends that, hey, he can sing
right.
A song.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I used to do that.
Yeah.
And people, you know,
yeah.
Whatever. And then I know for a fact, I've always been a very aware kind of a person.
Okay.
So I used to think people just clap because they're supposed to clap.
Right. And which is partially.
So I never really knew that I'm a good singer.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
You know? So this was the first stranger who told me randomly.
That is
so,
heavy. No, I take that my words back earlier. So it must have meant something, you know.
Yeah.
Because you remember it, right?
Because
now.
I remember it.
Yeah.
That was the first time a stranger
right.
told me.
Right.
So that's when because
shout,
I don't.
Shout out to that mate.
Yeah, because yeah, I don't know. I don't even know her name.
It's okay.
So anyway, so because I don't come from a non-musical background, so
right.
I didn't know there was this world that existed.
Okay.
You know, for me, it's like, bada hoke, you have to get a job.
Right.
And this thing.
Huh?
This is, I never saw this as a profession. And then,
Plus, it's hard. Plus, you have parents who will tell you what the fuck are you doing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But MTV came, VH1 came.
Right.
That time, indie music was
sure. Yeah.
Artists like Lucky Ali, Euphoria, all these guys were coming up.
That was a revolution, bro.
Mohit Chauhan, Silk Road, that was his band. So, I used to listen to those songs and then I used to watch them perform. You know, videos they used to show on MTV. MTV used to be fucking awesome. And I was like, hey, that is fun. Yeah. And I sing as well. I used to just stand there, watch those concerts on TV and just sing along.
Nice.
You know? And then I think that's where I saw Live Aid first.
Okay.
Queen Ka.
Okay.
And then I was like, hey, I want to do that, you know? Yeah.
The music thing.
Yeah. Okay. So, and I didn't know you could do it. I could do it professionally.
Mm.
Till this one time, that same friend who I used to jam with, we walked into this bar which used to have an open mic night.
Pune?
Back in 2006. Pune, Korega Park.
Okay.
And we just went there and there's this open mic night happening. Like,
Anyone can...
Anyone can come sing and even play with the musicians.
Right.
And they were senior musicians, Chris and Mike.
Right.
They still perform.
Okay.
So, we went up to the owner of the place, the two of us. We were 15.
Okay.
And you're like, hey, we would like to perform here.
Huh.
Like, we saw two people performing there.
Right.
I was like, hey, even you play guitar and I sing.
Okay.
So we can do this as well. And
right.
Like, look at people clapping and shit, right? So this guy goes like, the owner goes like, hey, it's open mic night. Why don't you all do a song?
Right.
So then this is the point where reality hits you, right?
Yes, abhi ho sakta
hai. This is the part where you realize it. Talking about something and doing something are completely two different things.
Right.
Because the moment I hit the stage, I went on stage, I was like shooting bricks, dude. I was like, whoa. And suddenly everyone goes quiet and they're waiting for us to perform. And then I was like, whoa, what is this? Okay. And then I closed my eyes.
Did
and
you
I
blank
sang,
out or did you sing?
And I sang Hotel California.
Okay. All right. Nice.
That's
nice.
Like the most cliche song, right? And then people clapped,
right.
You know, and they really clapped. And then I was like, hey, this is a good feeling.
Right.
So, went down in that person, the owner, he was like, you sing well, but the thing is like, you have stage fright. So, come every Sunday and just sing with these guys.
Right.
So, we started doing that. Then, one person who owned a restaurant saw us over there. She came up to us and offered our first contract.
Oh,
so
nice.
That's how I started doing gigs.
Right.
From 15, 16.
So you write songs as well, right?
I write songs as well and I didn't realize it's a thing.
Okay.
I was like,
So now I want to know your method. Like, how do you write songs? Because writing is something that I relate to. So I really want to know that how do you write your songs? So is it based on music? So the music is created and then you put words into it? Or do you just write stuff and then...
You can do it anyhow. Like, a song is like...
How do you do it? Like, I'm sure people do it...
So, in I know. The thing is, like, I've done it. I've used all different ways and techniques approaches...
Okay.
Towards writing songs, like my different songs, some songs I wrote the lyrics first,
okay,
and then I
added the
check the phrasing, and then added the melody, made the melody over it. Sometimes I come up with a good tune in my head, and then I write songs over. I try to write words to it, and like there are times when I just have an idea. Okay, there's this song. This is what I want to convey.
Right.
And then...
It's pretty much like story.
Yeah, it's like a story.
Yeah.
So, one way is to write a song from a third person perspective where you're actually telling your listener a story.
Right.
And the other way is...
Can you give an example of a famous song?
Like, for example, Steven Wilson. If you all listen to Steven Wilson, I think that album is a concept album.
Okay.
For example, this is... I'm using this as an example. Now, if you listen to every song in the order it is, it's like telling us a story.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
Cool.
Song 1
is
like chapter 1.
Hmm.
Song 2 is like chapter 2. And it tells you a story.
Right.
So that's one way of writing songs.
Understood. Yeah.
The other way of writing songs is like what people like Damon Rice or John Mayer do.
Right.
Like it's like a one-on-one conversation with the listener. Like that's what I feel. See, hey, there's no particular set way of writing, you know. So I'm mostly a self-taught musician, so that's the reason my words are a little simplistic.
Okay.
But the thing is, like, this is what I've understood from, you know, studying songs and the way, like, because I try to understand when I'm listening to a song that what was the songwriter thinking?
Exactly.
You know, when he wrote, he or she wrote this song.
What was going through his mind?
Yeah, exactly.
Right, right.
So, that is how, when I started thinking like that and started listening to songs,
right,
like, in any language, and so that's when I started noticing this difference.
Okay.
Like, some songwriters are talking from a third person's perspective. How did that get here, man?
I don't know. It's but I think I smashed it, right?
Is it because it's Red Bull?
Yeah, because it's orange. Exactly.
Oh, man.
Okay. Anyway. Yeah. Go for it. Then, did we zone out? Like, what were we talking
about? I zoned out. What were we talking about?
So you were talking about
first
person,
right?
Yeah, you were in a song. So
oh yeah, songwriting.
Exactly. So yeah. So third person. So maybe you're telling a story to the person. So it changes. You don't stick to one thing, right?
You don't. No. You don't need to stick to one thing. If you're a painter, will you just use the color blue?
No, but the way of painting will be, so you, that's how you differentiate one artist from the other.
This,
right?
Painting over here, nobody can see it, but it's. The main color I would say is green.
Right.
So but if you keep using this thing, every painting will look the same, like this. Am I making sense?
Yeah, but there's another thing to that. So if people know that when they see Van Gogh, what's that famous painter? Vincent.
Van Gogh,
yeah, Van Gogh. So when they see a Van Gogh work, they know it's Van Gogh work. Or when they see
Hussein's
work, they know.
Okay, I know what you're coming at.
Right.
What you're talking about is
style,
the signature style of
making.
What's
yours?
That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the way, like, for example, I can't give every song of mine the same melody.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, makes sense. Yes.
Yeah. But the way I present the song should be unique. Like no other songwriter.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Like that. Yeah. So that is what the prime focus is.
So do you listen to music while you're composing your own? Like, do you listen to other stuff?
Maybe. No, actually, I refrain from doing that. Because if I listen to a lot of music while writing or composing a song, then I tend to get influenced by that particular song or that song.
Yeah.
And I don't want this to sound like anything that already exists.
Yeah. You know what I really want to talk about? What is your favorite band? Like
Queen.
All time favorite. When you are growing up, right, especially in India, right, 90s, early 90s. So mostly you're exposed to Bollywood, because MTV and VH1, they came later.
Yeah.
Right. So earlier it was all Bollywood, and my parents were a huge Michael Jackson fan. They loved Michael Jackson. So I grew up listening to a lot of Michael Jackson. I was a big fan, but I was like, yeah, that's the only Western exposure I have at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And when I grew up, right, so then Backstreet Boys happened, and that was at that time.
Oh, fuck yeah. Right.
You know, Backstreet, now people are like, you know, because suddenly so Backstreet Boys has this amazing thing, because earlier everyone was dancing on "That Makes You Larger Than Life." But a few years later, you know, this thing came up. You listen to Backstreet Boys? That is so gay, right? Have you ever experienced?
Yeah, but this is 2019. Let me come to that topic. Like, what is wrong in being gay?
No. That time we didn't.
We've come from a background where being black is bad. Being gay is bad.
At that time, being gay was out of the topic,
no, it's
right?
It's just like, whoa, what the fuck?
Because worldsex.com told me something else about gays. And then I was like, do they listen to Backstreet Boys? So the point is that, you know, that was the thing.
I didn't even think about this.
So I was like, that's
you're
not me.
Weird kid, man.
I was like, that's
how old
were
you?
When the dial-up thing was new, right? Because that's where you...
This is the 90s, yeah.
Yeah, 90s. I was in 6th or 7th grade. So whatever, that was Backstreet Boys.
When did you do your 10th? Like, how old?
I'm 30, bro. I'm 31.
What are you saying, man? I thought you were just two years apart.
Yeah. So anyway, getting back to that. So Backstreet Boys happened, and then you meet girls, you fall in love, you crush, and then you start listening to
those songs. Talking about the chronology.
Yeah, exactly. Because I really want to share how I reached to Linkin Park. Because that was...
Oh, fuck, yeah. Linkin Park was a phase I think everyone has gone through.
I haven't...
At one point, I think I was in like the 6th standard.
Mm-hmm.
6th, 7th standard.
Same, 7th.
So, yeah.
So I started listening to Bon Jovi and Boyzone because of
Yeah, I had a Nirvana phase that time.
But
that
because
time
of a girl.
I used to listen to Nirvana.
But because of a girl, right? And then suddenly this... So MP3s came new into business. MP3s were new, right? So then you were like 150 songs in a CD, what the fuck? And then I heard this song called Don't Stay by Linkin Park for the first time. I didn't know what Linkin Park was.
Yeah.
It sounded funny, Linkin Park. The name sounded funny. I was in my 7th standard. I played the fucking MP3. I heard this song. Bro, my life changed. And it has been the same abhi tak. Because I've been Linkin Park.
Changed in what way?
Music. For the first time, I actually heard a band that was like my thing. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Because earlier it was like, oh, people are listening to it. It's famous. It sounds nice. Yeah, I'm listening to Backstreet Boys. Oh, I like this girl. She listens to Boyzone. So I want to listen to Boyzone. And I'm thinking about her. But then finally, when I heard Linkin Park, I was like, yeah, this is my kind of music. So the way you connected to Queens, right? I don't know how that happened.
Yeah, because I think everyone has that one artist or one band. Or like, I think everyone has a favorite actor, favorite thing like that.
So
yeah.
Chester Bennington happened, right? Earlier, I used to laugh at people who used to get sentimental because of some artist who died, right? So my mother loved Devanand, huge fan. And when Devanand died, he was an actor,
he
right?
died recently.
Yeah,
yeah.
When I don't know when, but when Devanand died, my mother cried, and I'm like, and when Michael,
you know
Jackson,
why? It's all about nostalgia. Now Devanand. Whenever she remembers Devanand,
right.
For example, her brain associates her time.
Memories attached.
Yeah.
Like smell.
That's what art does.
Yeah.
Right? For example, why do you like a particular song? Like,
it reminds you of
exactly.
time or
something. Suddenly, this. Transports you back to school.
Pyramids,
you know?
And that
exactly.
big ass key.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Suddenly.
Yeah.
It's all about that's what
that's magic,
songs
man.
Do,
that's
man.
Like,
that is
yeah.
what art does in general.
So when Michael Jackson died, my sister cried. I was like, what shit, man.
Yeah.
When Chester died,
same.
Chester died very recently. I was a grown ass man.
Yeah.
Bro, I went inside a room and I cried. Like, not wine like a
yeah, because
woman,
like he's become
were,
a part of you.
There were tears in my eyes. And then I thought that
that
no
is
more,
their legacy. You.
Yes. And no more. The sad part was that it's not like the memories that Linkin Park has given me. It's like I won't hear that voice again in a different song anymore.
Exactly.
That's what I really want.
Yeah, I think that is how all grief is, right? That won't happen again.
Yeah.
That's basically what everything is like. Breakups also. That's that.
Yeah,
won't,
that won't happen again. Ever, is movies the big thing? Like that's where you want to go?
Movies would be a good platform because
yeah.
a lot of people listen to songs. Like, so the main part about people knowing a musician in India over here
is
the way they consume his or her music.
Hmm.
Like, for example, people don't buy CDs anymore. People don't buy cassettes anymore.
Yeah.
What is the source of music? Like, how do you get updated now? You tell me.
Through apps. Like,
with what apps?
Like a family, mostly Spotify.
Mostly
Spotify.
Spotify is also comparatively new
very
in India.
Relatively, yeah, very new.
What have you been doing in the past, let's say, 5 years?
Okay, so since TV, you know, VH1.
Do you still watch TV?
Not anymore.
Exactly.
It's
I'm
anymore.
Asking you 5 years, what have you been doing?
How 5 years
do you know?
TV, but if you say 1 or 2 years.
Internet.
Yeah, I was coming to that, but 5 years was TV, but last 2 years, yeah, internet.
Yeah. So, what kind of songs do you get to hear randomly the most?
Mostly electronic. Because
mostly electronic because electronics is what...
It has taken over,
electronic.
Right?
Electronics.
Oh, yeah. Electronic
music. I like to correct myself as well.
Dude, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. So, electronic music. And I'm a huge Deadmau5 fan.
Great.
Yeah.
So, basically, that is your taste. So, you get to see that.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? So, every person has his or her own way to consume music.
And the algorithm feeds
what
you
is,
very...
What is the the maximum amount of people, like how do I put this, a larger percentage of the population
right.
listens to Bollywood.
Sure, yeah.
So, an artist will be heard the most from that platform
right.
in India.
In India, yeah.
In India. So that's where I'm coming to is
right.
like that is the reason movies won't be a bad idea. Like, you know, that's where you can...
To be honest, actually, that's where you'll be successful. Like,
because that's how you people listen to. How many people actually do you know that do research? Okay, let's see what are the new artists right now.
No, I don't think
so. How many people, like back in the day, used to go to a shop and used to see like
cassettes and CDs.
CDs and cassettes. Yes. Okay, this section, this is new. This is like how books are there, right? People have stopped buying music. That physical copy of having a CD and cassette, feeling has gone.
Right.
What
do you think is happening to albums? It's okay if it's albums, YouTube
that's,
channel.
That's exactly what I'm like. But because where of the internet, right?
Right.
Our attention span has reduced.
Sure. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
People back in the day when they used to buy albums, they used to buy albums.
Yeah.
So they had to listen to the entire thing, like in a row and the way the artist has made it.
Yeah.
Right now, you can individually click a song.
And we can't cry about it because it's kind of an evolution, right? We can't just...
You shouldn't cry about it because change is imminent. I mean, you can't stop change.
Right.
If you decide to be stubborn and get stuck, okay, fine, I just have this way of presenting my music, then you won't go anywhere. You have to go with the times.
Right.
Right.
So, if you have to... Sure, movie is in your crosshairs that you want to make it big and... sing for a big movie, which will be awesome.
Yeah.
But what about your album? Like, you want to come up with a hit single, your YouTube
so
channel.
That's what I have been
Do you
doing.
Think it's missing right now? Because I don't see many individual artists coming with this album wala rather than a flashy YouTube video.
Now, the trend has changed. Now, we are in a this thing, you know, that era of change. When so, this is a very good time because... the internet has suddenly sprung up with a lot of new artists.
Sure.
You know, soon in 5 years' time, I think that will be the major platform for entertainment.
Right.
Like people don't watch TV anymore. I mean, viewership for television has reduced considerably over the years. Right. How many people do you know who watch TV every day?
My mom.
Your mom.
Yeah.
And my mom as well. Yeah. Exactly.
Mom and Dad. I don't know any of our age group.
We all are like internet people.
Yeah, 100%.
So basically, it's going to come to a point where everyone's source of entertainment is through the internet.
Right.
And internet is very selective. You see only what you want to see.
Yeah, the algorithm. Yeah, it feeds you what you have liked or... You
so know. Maybe it's become... That's how it's become more difficult for musicians. Because they have to make sure that everything that they put out...
Right.
Every song should be the best.
Right.
So that adds
that's a difficult thing.
Plus, it's difficult. Not just that, because the remuneration is not as much as what they used to have back in the day.
Sure,
Like, even if you get musicians were millionaires back in the 80s and 90s, man.
Yeah. Like, but wasn't a normal musician happy because he got less money, but still he was getting to do what he loved? Not everyone is not going to be Sonu Nigam, right?
Okay, you're talking about a very different topic. So here's the thing, as a professional musician who's been doing it for 14 years, I hate the fact that there's this cliche going around that musicians are strugglers.
Okay,
you know?
It's
just like any job.
Any other freelance, right?
Exactly. You pick up projects.
Right.
You do gigs,
right?
Like, and you do it in a cycle. So at the end of the month,
you're doing what you really love. You're making money out of it.
Yeah, exactly. You're making money, right? So, and you're doing what you love.
Right.
So this is what a lot of people are not aware of.
Right.
Especially parents, because for them it's
more like contrary to what people.
Yes,
think, yeah.
Because your source of income is always from an orthodox job.
A job, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So, this is also, there are different ways. I mean, we are lucky to be alive at this time.
Yes.
Exactly. That we can be like YouTubers and that can be our main profession.
Like put a camera inside a room.
Have some Red Bull.
Right.
And just talk to each other. Man, this is our profession. Imagine.
This
is great.
It's kind of crazy.
It's
amazing. What do you think is next for music?
I'm not that, I don't consider myself like anyone who's qualified to make that statement that what will happen to music now. you know, but
no, this is just to, you know,
I don't want my music.
No. So you know, it started from Walkman and then Discman.
Okay, yeah. See, here's the thing, that here's iPod. The good part.
Now internet is here, sure. So the thing is Spotify. We are doing Spotify. Do you ever think that what in next 10 years?
20 years down the line, maybe this is not the way people consume music.
How the hell are they going to consume music then?
No idea. Like, do you think if you travel back in time, if time traveling is a thing, right?
Yeah, nobody
knew. If you speak to a person in the 80s from the 80s, right? They can't even imagine there'd be something called MP3 20 years
yes.
ago. So we can't even imagine what's going to be there in the next 20 years.
Just to humor us.
That's how, like, technology is, man. I mean, you can't, and it's scary, man. Imagine, like, 30, 40 years down the line, we will be the old people who are struggling with current technology.
Right. And what would that be, man?
We look at these videos and be like, ha, primitive. You know?
Yeah.
Like, this is how people used to be.
Right.
Like, you know how you watch the old black and white videos and movies?
Right.
I was like, their production is so primitive. Now you're thinking like that, right? But back then, that was the shit. You know?
Absolutely, man. Bro, anything that you want to share? So far, you've spent 14 years, and that's a lot of time.
That's nothing, actually. People spend 50 years, 60 years.
But you plan to. That's what I really want to know. Is this your thing?
This is what I want to do. Like,
that's
this
it,
is,
right?
Yeah.
You sorted for you know.
Sorted. I know. Of course, I have my ups and downs. But this is what I want to do. This is what keeps me happy. This is what keeps me sane. I think this profession is very human. You know, because my basic job is, any musician's basic job is to express.
Right.
You know, like, how many jobs and professions do you know that your main job is to express?
Very few. If they are not art-based, no.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Right. I'm not talking shit about those other professions.
But like, they are.
No. The thing is, like, everything is necessary.
Yeah.
Like, it's all about moderation, right? Without doctors, what the fuck? Everyone is a singer, everyone is a musician. I'm like, holy shit, who's going to save us, bro? Speaking of which, I still have to go for that physio thing.
Oh, yeah. let's get back to the. So, how do you. So, you, I'm sure you're a fucking nocturnal guy because you sleep late or maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
And you are
regular. And plus, the weather is better at night.
Oh, yeah.
Especially in Bombay, I mean.
But I speak to a lot of people who are into Ayurveda and all. They say, do not do that. It's going to harm you in the long run. It doesn't matter if you get your 8 hours of sleep, but if you're not sleeping at night, right? And you're not waking up early in the morning.
Day and night.
In the longer run.
Day and night and time is all perspective.
It's perspective, but it will.
Time doesn't exist. You make it.
You might change.
For example, I'll tell you that.
Right.
I'll give you an example. If I am someone who sleeps every day at 3 a.m.
3 a.m., yeah.
Yeah. And I wake up every day at 9:30.
Mm-hmm.
6.5 hours of sleep.
That's good. I'm not saying ki. Yeah.
So 6.5 hours of sleep. After waking up at 9:30, I go on my normal diet.
Mm-hmm.
I try to squeeze in 4 or 5 meals.
Right.
So basically, my body clock is the same as a healthy person.
Right.
But at the same time, it's just shifted.
Yeah, so that shift is what I'm really concerned about. We will get back to your fitness routine as well. So since you've been, since that's how I really know you, like, you're a fitness guy.
I wouldn't be, I still don't think I'm qualified to make fitness.
Sure, you aren't. I know that definitely. Because I've met a few who are.
So. Yeah, exactly. Oh, fuck, yeah, I've seen your episodes. Yeah, and they are my friends. So I wouldn't want to start making fitness.
That'll be like, you know.
That'll just be make us look stupid, man. Let's stick to what we do.
your friends will like this, play some fucking guitar, bro.
Yeah, man.
But tell me, so when did you get into, you know, okay, I need to look good, like, aesthetically?
Like my best friend Dhruv.
Shout out to
Dhruv. So we literally grew up together, like,
really?
We met around 10th standard or something like that.
Okay.
And I'm seeing the guy.
How many 1-inch punches have you taken? Like, did he ever
recently no, but as kids, like, all his friends, like, his couple of close friends were his guinea pigs.
Okay.
So basically, all the one.
Was he a bully? Because he doesn't look like one.
He wasn't a bully. I don't think, because he wasn't.
To friends, you know.
So
I'll show you something.
He's not. We weren't in the same school.
Okay.
We met through that same music friend who I started performing with. Yeah. So he was my classmate, and then this guy used to stay in his society.
Okay.
So that's how we met and we became friends because football used to happen and then we used to...
The way dudes are, right?
Whatever.
Just, yeah, let's just fucking...
Yeah, you just... Yeah. How do people become friends, you know? That's... You can't really answer that, right?
It's... Yeah.
So, I mean, and so back then, there was this garden or playground sort of a place where we used to chill.
Mm.
And there was this rock we used to sit on and there was this goalpost. And we used to talk to him. We used to just sit and talk. We used to sit and talk and this guy's doing pull-ups over there.
When he was?
In 16.
Okay.
I think, yeah.
All right.
So basically, he started doing pull-ups then.
Yeah.
And I always used to see this. Okay, this guy can do this. This guy can do this. And strength is something which is very necessary. Like, in general, I think everyone should work on strength training.
Okay.
I think this much I can make as a statement.
Sure, sure.
Yeah. Everyone should work on strength training. It's a good thing. So, and then I had a bad diet. I used to just go eat once a day in college and then
go home. I was on momos, wraps and all that.
No. My diet in college was one Maggie a day.
Same, yeah.
Geez. Yeah. Only time I used to eat proper food was breakfast because that's when I used to leave for college.
Right.
So, that time I used to get ghar ka khana.
Right.
So, I'm eating good food, one meal. Around 3 or 4 in the evening, I used to have Maggie.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Huh.
And then full day, I used to keep drinking soft drinks.
Okay. And beers, college?
No, never. Hmm. Was never a beer person.
Okay.
I had an old monk phase.
Oh, nice. Who did you, man?
Yeah, yeah. So,
old monk book. Yeah.
Yeah. Then I shifted from alcohol to...
Protein.
Beep!
Oh!
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So, but that's, again, to each his own.
Yeah, okay.
2014, I sort of had this thing. I think heartbreak or something.
Breakup?
That happened.
A global motivator for people.
But that wasn't the reason.
Okay.
So, I was like, I had a lot of free time that time and I had just graduated.
Hmm.
And I wasn't doing anything. I was just chilling.
Right.
And my other best friend and Dhruv, you know. I was like, okay, chalo, let's just join multi-fit.
Right.
So I started working out, and then the thing is like, my body naturally produces a lot of testosterone.
Okay.
I was just saying. So.
How the fuck do you know that?
Because I did a test.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or are you getting bonus 24/7 a day? Like this must be.
24/7 a day.
I would have definitely had
to go to the hospital.
Sure.
Because 24 hours a day, who the fuck has
like
bonus?
What I meant was,
whoa.
What I meant was frequently. But anyway, so your body naturally produced a lot of testosterone.
I had a lot of acne problem and all that shit. So that's the reason I just did this test. Just normal health test you do, right?
Right.
So. This is something which is very unrelated. I connected the dots later that why suddenly.
Hmm.
So I started working out in basic push-ups and, rows and whatever. And then my body started changing and I could see the difference. And then my friends like Dhruv and my other friend Rishabh, they were like, you should eat more.
Right.
You know, then I started eating more, like a lot of rice and all that shit. So I used to be skinny,
right.
57 kgs at 5'11".
Okay.
So... I started eating a lot and then working out became a daily thing because I didn't have anything else to do. So I used to spend all my day in multi-fit in the gym.
Okay.
And Dhruv was there.
Right.
So we used to just chill there basically. I used to work out full day, take a half an hour break and then chill outside, play chess and then again work out again.
Okay.
So, you know, and then go home.
Right.
And practice or whatever.
Yeah.
Right. So... I started seeing a change and then my picture started looking better.
Right.
Then I was like, hey, this is great.
This is great. Yeah,
and
that's a nice
You
feeling.
Feel better, you know,
mm-hmm.
Your immunity goes up.
Right.
Like, you know.
You're eating healthier.
Eating healthier, you feel stronger and the fact that you can do like things which you couldn't do physically earlier, like pull-ups, dips.
Right, right.
You know, right? You suddenly can do that. So it's a good feeling.
Does it help you in your music?
Music, it helps me.
While working out, it's hard.
Singing.
Okay. But tell me something. While working out, you might not be able to think that much about your lyrics or music or whatever. Because,
there's a constant music player going on in my head. Like when I'm standing, working out,
right.
I'm just thinking.
Oh, nice.
I think a lot of people have this. I've spoken to a lot of people, musicians or non-musicians.
I know,
a plan. There's just this constant song playing in your head. Some anything that you've listened to earlier.
Right.
Like suddenly, yeah, Bohemian Rhapsody playing in your head.
Right. So where are you planning to take your music? Like, what's the full stop like?
Across the world, man. As long as many people should this thing listen to.
Why don't you get on Spotify?
I am on Spotify.
Fuck, I didn't know that.
So the thing is like, but the thing is like, the music that is available on Spotify, by me, right? It's this album released 12 years ago. Sorry, 10 years ago. No, not 10 years.
See,
ago.
The name
when was 2012?
It was 8 years ago. Yeah.
It's called Center of Origin.
Center of Origin.
Yeah,
the album is called Center of Origin.
Center of Origin, but it's like really early work that wasn't even supposed to be an album.
Okay.
I just recorded a few songs and then I was like, hey, let's just
Center
put this
of
up. Origin. But
Origin.
The songs that I started making after that,
yeah,
was for the second album that I was planning to release as a LP,
right,
which is still in works,
right,
and I think hopefully by the end of this year,
right,
something will be out. So,
so is it the same that we see on your Insta, the songs that you compose yourself? What's the song called? This is the song.
Fastly is one of my songs. You can check it out on YouTube, SoundCloud. Yeah.
Okay.
So, it's basically.
Go for it, bro.
One second, I'd have to tune this.
That's a fancy ass guitar, bro.
Not really, there are fancier guitars.
I've never seen an acoustic with all this digital light and stuff, that's why.
There are people, I mean, you get better guitars, man. I mean, I love this guitar because this is like.
Memories?
Like, she is. My girlfriend.
I'm sure. I understand
yeah.
that. Things that you do to the guitar.
Yeah, man. Okay, so this is Fastly.
Right.
And this is a very small part of the small version of the song I'm going to do. Check out the studio version.
Right.
It's out on YouTube.
Right.
SoundCloud. And is it on Spotify? I think it'll be out soon.
Okay, so, and if people have to search for the artist, so Raushan.
It's Raushan, so I spell my name as R-A-U-S-H-A-N.
Right.
V-E-R-M-A. I have to say this out loud every time because usually people spell Raushan as
R-O-S-H-A-N
and it's really annoying, man.
As if you
Stop
have
it.
Six fingers.
No,
in
because.
Your hand.
No. That, bad joke. Okay, Raushan is supposed to be pronounced as Ra.
Ra.
Yeah, so that's A-U.
Yeah, it's not Ro, it's Ra.
It's R-O becomes Raushan.
Yeah.
That's. Does make sense. So this is the song Fastly. Phir adhuri kahani vahi Phir meethi zubani vahi Khamosh mein खामोश तुम ऐसे कैसे बताएं मैं यहाँ तुम यहाँ मगर फासले कितने पास होकर भी साथ होकर भी अजनबी अजनबी वो रातें खुश नसीब थी जो बातों से तुम्हारे खिल जाती वो बातें भी अजीब थी जब हंसते हंसते हम सो जाते फिर ऐसी ही रात है फिर ऐसी ही बात है तुम कहाँ मैं यहाँ तुम यहाँ मगर फासले कितने पास होकर भी
साथ होकर भी अजनबी अजनबी
रहे. So, yeah.
That's awesome.
Thanks, man. That's called Fastlane.
That's crazy.
So, yeah, check it out. It's got Sarod, Abhishek Borkar playing Sarod on it. It's great. Check the song out. The studio version is a different experience.
True, I'm going to share this with a lot of people. That was awesome. That was nice.
Thank
you for being on the show, bro.
Thanks for having me. I hope we keep meeting again.
Sure. Whenever I visit Mumbai, bro.
Definitely. Come for a gig. People should follow me on Instagram.
We are going to share your details, bro.
Yeah,
absolutely. On this note. Man pound, bro. It was awesome. Boom. Thanks. Boom. Cheers.
Cheers.